So, welcome to a slightly unusual.
Oh.
You alright?
It's on again.
What's happening? So, now it's just finished bashing itself. Welcome to a slightly unusual video. It's an unboxing video of all the stuff that we bought from the baby show. The baby show, it was a bit weird, wasn't it?
Exhausting.
Overwhelming. Most expos and shows and those sorts of things, what do you call them? Just expos, I guess.
It's
not quite common.
Trade shows.
Even if you're not necessarily going to buy something, they can still be quite interesting because you learn quite a lot about what's there and about the subject. This one, I'm not sure that there's any real need to go unless you're really looking to buy something. Like the photography show, I love. Like I could go there, even if there was nothing I particularly wanted to buy, I'd probably end up buying something. But you could go without having a plan to buy something and you'd still learn things. The baby show, if you're not buying things, it's just weird and a bit overwhelming. But if you are buying things, incredibly useful. Particularly what we found for buying prams was essentially most of the main shops. So Mamas and Papas, John Lewis, Mothercare doesn't exist anymore.
Mamas and Papas and John Lewis.
Yeah, Mamas and Papas and John Lewis. they sell the same six brands. And so actually being able to go and see all the other brands that are available, if you're interested in Phil and Ted's, although they weren't actually at the show this time, or Cybex or Junior Jones that we looked at, that was one of our other high options. They were really good. And just actually being able to see and try a lot more range of prams and bits and pieces is, yeah, it's really interesting actually. So I thoroughly recommend it. And they had some stuff that was available just to be able to pick up then and there, but then other stuff needed to be ordered. So that's why we've now got a massive delivery. So the delivery driver was really pleased to be able to come and deliver all five boxes this morning in the middle of lockdown. So we're going to do an unboxing and just sort of show you how it all arrives and how it all goes together. And that's about it. So I reckon we start with the base. Congratulations, it's a Mios. Straps. Might look at the instructions. Wheel. Adapter. So we went with the Cybex Mios because
I wanted something compact. And it does fold down pretty
tiny.
Neatly.
Yeah. So many
between
of them.
This one and the pre-am, wasn't it?
Yeah. And the pre-am's quite large. A lot of the ones that we were looking at, so like the, I've forgotten the names of all of them now, but like the peach, what was that one?
The candy.
The eye candy peach, the bugaboo fox. We didn't really, because actually that doesn't really fold down. That just gets lower. What we wanted was something that took up very little floor space. And so some of them fold so they'll stand upright. Some of them just don't seem to get any smaller. They just get slightly lower. The upper baby Vista was the other one we looked at. And they were certainly, they were good contenders, but they were so massive.
And heavy.
And we just
don't have space.
Yeah, we don't have the space, but also, and there's something that I'm kind of speaking to my brothers about this. If you buy a massive pram that's really good for the bassinet for the first 4-6 months, it can be an incredible buggy for that bit. But then actually when you're then, Pip's helping. When you actually then get into the pram bit, you've then got a massive pram that you don't necessarily need quite such a big pram. So we decided to go for something that's possibly better from 4 months on. Possibly, but will work really well up to 4 months because we got the bassinet that went with it. So hopefully it's the best of both. It's finding that middle ground and it's finding what works for you. If you do have loads of cardboard left over, you could always try the camera obscura thing, which I did in another video. Should we do that again?
Maybe.
Be more convinced.
Okay, it's the main cover. Okay. Actually.
Okay. One of the things there's lots of information about is apparently you should let your dog, if you have a dog. If you don't have a dog, it's less important. But essentially, if you have a dog, you should let your dog smell everything.
Baby-related.
That's baby-related. So it doesn't just see it as a kind of foreign invader. And that's where actually getting it, if you can, getting it before the baby comes along so the dog can just get used to having all this extra stuff in the house is apparently a good thing.
I'm guessing that is a little bit. It's useful. I didn't know that was coming. Good. So, unpackage shoveling.
Yeah.
And then... we're going to put it up and then put the wheels on.
Okay. And then decide what we're putting in it. This is where we have to remember how to actually put it up.
So you want the handle.
Yeah.
So you press and then pull towards you.
Yeah.
There you go.
There you go.
Can be easy with it.
Yeah, simple. That I really like the fact that as you lay it back, it articulates around the hips.
Mm.
So it's not just a straightforward bend. It's kind of a bend and stretch. Apparently is one of the things that they're really proud of.
Mm.
And to put it down, fold everything forward. And then and it's self-standing.
Yeah.
Ooh, pretty lining.
Mmm. It's about that. Okay. So we need the little foot.
Is that the little foot?
Yeah, thing? It might be.
Okay.
Which I think slots in. Okay.
Way up, do we think it goes? Is the most ridiculous tiny little bit of detail is the bit that's causing most stress. Should we try turning it over again?
Yeah, it was kind of easy actually doing it that way, but
you couldn't do it easily on your own. Right, the least interesting bit of the whole thing is now done. Right, what do we do now?
So fuzzy.
Oh, carbon fiber.
And then we want to guide this on with that through it.
Okay.
So
I'm guessing that's the back. Right, now I'm just going to take this. So
I think, unless that's that.
Yeah, I think that.
So, yeah, if you bring the seat.
Yeah. More zips.
Good. So there should be... that should go... around that sort of levery bit of the top.
Okay.
Simple in theory, but not in practice.
Oh, yeah. I suspect this is a sign of things to come with trying to get children into clothes. Actually, the end of that was much easier than pop these into place. No. I think they don't pop together.
That might need to.
Yeah, that's to do with the hood. I think.
That bit's done.
That bit's done. Yeah, this was one of the things that we really liked about this design. It's actually for summer, you can take this back padding off and it's just a mesh back so they don't get too hot.
So it should just
Does it need click onto the waist bed? Oh, I see.
The popper, yeah, it's going to the popper. Should guide it in.
There you go. Okay.
That's a handy one.
When you get it right. There we go.
So that's already all in place. Yeah, I don't know what. There's more poppers here. And the they go in here.
I think they pop under.
Oh yeah, what's that?
I'm not sure that can go over there. I don't know what all the fuss was about. Well done, Pip. You helped. Here you go, rain cover. Done, sorted. Simple. Right, so we got the pram sorted. Now I just need to sort out the other bits. So, I think what we decided was, thankfully we won't have to do that again.
Yeah.
Like, it was fairly straightforward. It took us probably about an hour.
It's a bit of a fiddle.
It's just a bit of a fiddle. But all the bits that are a bit of a fiddle, you won't have to do again. Mios your life. Right, there we go, sorted.
Another rain cover. Mm-hmm. All right.
Blessed be the fruit.
That's more effective, that one.
Is it?
Yeah. You have to push the ball down. It goes click.
Push the floor down until it goes click. So there's two little strip bars in there. That's quite nice to have a handle to hold on to. Oh, that's good. There's a little handle in here that actually helps you.
Oh, right.
Click it.
Really,
I wonder whether the handle is more designed to put it down.
Yeah, lots of ventilation.
Yeah, massive ventilation.
I think that unzips as well. You can bring it forward. Or have I just unattached it?
You've just unattached it. So they can see out if they like tummy time.
Alright.
Yeah, that's what they're for, the brochures. Yeah, that zips right down.
Okay, that's nice.
Oh, I like these. I'd forgotten I liked them. The memory buttons.
Oh, you don't need to put that on.
No, the adapters, I think, are purely for the car seat.
Oh, right, okay.
Yeah,
here
you
go. So they should be labelled right and left.
Also, you can't put them on the wrong way around. They've got a... No, but genuinely, they've got
okay,
a...
Good.
They've got a thing, which means... that's what I just tried.
Okay.
You can't put them on the wrong way around. This is the pretty one, right?
I'm very excited about this.
I'm so excited about this. So Cybex do a whole lot of different fabrics. And they do plain black, but we decided we want to go for the navy blue, nautical blue feather seat and the bassinet. You can also get this in like a rose gold and a chrome.
Yeah, I think so.
Rose gold, chrome, or chrome and black, or just black. We went with just the black. But what's interesting is when you actually look on the website, the fabrics that we were, Emma likes flowers, and they had two floral patterns, which we thought looked absolutely beautiful, until we saw them in real life and realized that they were bejeweled. And if that's your thing,
great.
That's completely reasonable. I'm happy for you to have bejeweled crowns, but it's not our thing. But this one, which actually I've written off from looking at online, looks pretty cool in reality. So this is the koi fabric.
How's there? Nice.
Pretty koi. Yeah, the thing that we really liked about this was, again, it's got a great cover.
And
yeah.
Where my other my flapping
lights. Like that. Lift that. So this is a lie flat car seat. Now, apparently it's not lie flat in the car, but it is lie flat out the car. So when you put them in the pram, you then get to reset the 2-hour timer. And the fact that this, okay, so actually when it's lying flat, you cannot, that's quite a clever thing.
Okay.
Yeah, so those little buttons come across. Yeah, so unless it's in the fully upright position, you can't attach it into your car. Yeah, and then theoretically, this should just that was remarkably simple. Right, so actually, most of the video is going to be us struggling with zips. Now it's taken us 20 minutes,
yeah.
So an hour to do the first bit, 20 minutes to do all the rest. Wow, that's thrilling. look at how exciting that is.
Ooh.
Oh.
Makes noise.
Yeah. That's not going to get annoying at all, is it? No. No, stop making the noise now. Why is it making... PB?
Maybe unless it's green. Green and green.
Yeah.
So maybe we should try and put that in back.
Okay, so that's your legs down and in place. There. That's where the seat, because you can then turn the seat so that tells you that's not in the right place. And then if the seat is in it properly, that's it, it'll all go green. So yeah, so you can tell. So this is when they said it was light and sound.
I didn't pick up on that when they say that.
Well, they describe it as light and sound security or something like that. There must be a way to turn that off. Stop it now. So if you're wondering, this warning label, don't take this warning label off until you're ready to actually put it in the car, or else it does that a lot. And that's how you stop it beeping. And obviously only until you fit it. That's much less annoying. Right. Excellent. Next time, see us, we'll be putting this in the car. So we're gonna try and fit this in the car. What I think I've worked out, these things that came with it are for cars that don't have kind of the permanent built-in ISOFIX points to
to create essentially that same idea. So I don't think we need them, so that's good. I'll store them there and I'll forget about them completely. We also need to find somewhere to store these because they're going to get lost. We did decide to get, we're going to try and fit this. This is a seat protector that just should protect the seat. Because apparently children are dirty and nasty and horrible, this should stop there being too much lovely stuff. It's got this little tail that you're meant to stuff through somewhere, but I don't really know. Let's try and stuff it through. See how that works. This would be much easier if I had smaller fingers. That should just theoretically help protect
a nice upholstery.
A nice upholstery. I know that's pathetic. Deciding we need to protect a nice upholstery. It is a baby, and babies are more important than cars. This should be simple-ish. Okay, done. Kneeling on concrete.
There's towels in the back, isn't
there? Oh, towels in the back. Be nice. And again, this is the sort of thing that you do once and hopefully don't need to worry about doing again. So you got these extendy bits.
This one's gone green, isn't it?
Yeah, I think that's as green as it's going to go. There you go.
So what have you done there? You've literally...
I have no idea what I've done.
Clipped it to...
There you go.
And you push it back until it...
Yeah, until it's...
Secure.
Secure. And then you let the bottom leg down. Yeah, and then that's... So one place we've got green, green, red, green, green. The only one that's red at the moment is saying it doesn't have a baby seat in it.
Which is correct.
But I guess you just want it, yeah, because it stops it moving that way. And then, yeah, it still moves a bit. Is that right?
No idea. We can do some research on that.
Okay.
But it's impossible for it not to move at all.
Yeah. In. There you go. That was it. You can turn the baby, get the baby out. Okay. And you can turn the baby. So if you're on that side.
That's good.
Yeah.
Presumably not while travelling.
Not while travelling, but yeah, it goes green, 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 green. Quick question.
Yeah.
How do you think, so apparently there's also some question of where
that goes.
That goes.
I wondered that too. It's presumably you want it back
yeah, no,
to get the
you
baby
want it
in.
There.
You're going to need to have it back to get the baby in.
Yeah, so you can put it back, put the baby in. But then when you're actually driving, you want that locked.
Like a roll
it
bar.
Acts like a roll bar.
And you've got some, these funny things on the side as well.
Some cars apparently, or some seats, this can then lower down even further to here to act like a... So yeah, it's only apparently on the driver's side or the
door
car
side.
Yeah. Quick question, does that still turn around? Yeah, it does. How do you get it off the base?
So turn it around.
So it turns out there's a handle down here. This is brilliant footage, by the way. Handle down here that releases. So I guess if you, I don't know whether it works. Let's see, that's worth trying. So launch the baby out the front. So that presumably also means that you can sit it. Well, you can sit it in sideways as well.
Yeah.
So if the baby's in the car seat.
Right, should I give it a go?
Yeah, you give it a go.
Does it click in place, sort of?
Sort of. There you go. Actually more difficult putting it in.
Yeah.
when it's sideways.
Oh, there you go.
Yeah, you can do it, but it's not as easy. And of course, the most pointless thing in the world is the fact that our little fish is completely invisible when it's in the car.
Yeah, it's just kind of, we'll get used to that.
Yeah. It's definitely easier actually to take it in and out when it's in a locked position. Little bulrushes.
So, you've seen us unbox it all, badly. I just wanted to run through a couple of final things about why we got what we did and what we discovered when we were unboxing it. Yeah, one of the key things is it's actually a relatively compact stroller, pushchair, travel system, call it what you will. I don't know what the real technical difference is between any of those things, but I'm sure there probably is and people will tell me I'm wrong. Yeah, we wanted something that was small. We didn't mind that it had smallish wheels. This one does have suspension, so it's not too jolty. But people kept talking about going off-road. And I don't know how many people are going super off-road. It'll also be summer when she's born. And I don't know.
Carriers.
Yeah, we got carriers. And if you want to really go up mountains and hills, you're going to take a buggy. Maybe if you live on a farm, great. But I see way too many massive strollers in towns and in cities that just take up so much space. It doesn't have the biggest basket in the world, but it's got a basket, does exactly what it needs to do. And again, because it's one of the more compact ones, the handle position is not exhaustive. There's basically three settings, 1, 2, 3. But I'm 6'4", and this is perfectly high enough for me, and I don't feel like there's not enough space for me to be able to get my feet behind it. Now it'll lower low enough, so if you really want to, and if you lower it lower, gives you a little bit more space. So I'm a little bit more straight armed, but I don't know, it all just seems to work. It's got a massive sun hood, so that's the normal sun hood, and then it's extendable. And then you get a little flappy bit at the front as well. So it's a huge sun hood. And then a really nice little detail is this, what they call the secret peekaboo slot, which I guess peekaboo slots are a really useful idea, but this one is magnets. There are tiny little magnets there and there which keep it in place, which means that it's silent. So most of them are held in place by Velcro. So it's just a little detail that I quite like. The only thing I would say is, why isn't there a peekaboo slot when that's zipped up? That's the only thing that I would question. Because actually, what if you want a peekaboo slot now? I guess you could have that out and have that back by one and have
easier
that forward.
To have a look. Yeah, I suppose it's easier to look, isn't it?
But footrest, mesh, so it's gonna be staying relatively clean from grubby feet and all of that sort of stuff. Multiple different positions that it can stay in. You can have it wherever is most comfortable for them. Seat position, everything from right back. And again, I really like this sort of, it's articulated here. So it's not just a bend, it's kind of a bend and fold. And then collapsing it could not be more simple. And that's it. And it's not super light, but it's light enough that I can easily lift it. My wife can easily lift it. If you do that, you squash your dog. You kind of need to hold on to the middle when you put it back.
Not always. If there's a dog in the way.
It's really good and soft and padded. You can also take this bit off. So actually, when they get a bit older, they can just have an open mesh back if it's on a hot day. So they're not then sweating it here. And then just little details, where all the contrast colors and yeah, it's just nicely done.
What bothers you though?
What bothers me? Yeah, why is this upside down? I have tried all different combinations, because the problem is there are little location nubs on here that stop you putting it in the other way up. So it should, looks like to me, it should go that way up. And in terms of changing the seat, I think this is really neat. There are these little memory buttons where you press them
and they stay pressed. So you press one, two, three, and it just lifts off without having to try and press both and lift both at the same time. Then you've got the bassinet, which I think, yeah, bassinet can only be parent facing. The baby seat can be parent facing, or do they call it world facing?
Okay.
World facing, so you can have that either way around. Bassinet is obviously parent facing. You put the lid down, and again, comes with an extra sun hood as well. And then big cover that you can then clip into place higher up as well. And yeah, nice little details. Then you've got a ventilation cover just here. And then if you zip these down, you get a ventilation cover there as well. So actually in the summer, which is when our baby will be born, you can make them really cold. Apparently, if babies really like tummy time, there are words I'm saying that I never thought as an adult I'd say, but yeah, if babies like tummy time, they can see out, because that will be important to them. This comes with a base. I think I need to check again, and I'll just make sure that what it says, and anything I say I'm not endorsing, I am just saying what I have been told. But as far as I'm aware, this is suitable for occasional overnight use because of the ventilated mattress. Not an endorsement, just a suggestion of what I've been told. The brake is really simple. I've been getting my toe stuck because I think I'm just doing it wrong, where I keep trying to put my foot on top and pushing it down and it's getting it stuck. Really, you just need to kick it. You don't need to stick your whole toe in there. And I guess that's just with use and practice, you'll work out exactly where it is. But yeah, the brake is nice and solid. These, very simple, pretty much foolproof. You can't actually put them on the wrong way because there's a thing which stops them sliding into place. So if they're sliding on, they're right around. And then this goes in. And yeah, one of our reasons for choosing this particular baby seat, this car seat, is the fact that it does lie flat. So there are rules on how long you can keep the baby in the car seat in its squashed position. Don't squash your babies. I think in the first 6 weeks it's half an hour, and over 6 weeks it's 2 hours. But this means in the flat position that kind of resets that. So actually, if you want to be able to take your baby to the shops and you just need to nip in for 5 minutes or whatever it is, you can keep them in this seat, put them in here, lie them flat, and then put them back in the car, squash them again, and then drive home. So again, not a recommendation or an endorsement, but just something that is possible. Absolutely enormous hood. Again, aim when it's back, it's pretty well protected, and it's got a pretty koi carp on it, and that was one of my main reasons for choosing this design, that I think it's quite pretty. So this has got little bulrushes and nice koi carp. It's also got the Buzz Lightyear wings, which is a side impact protection system.
For the car.
Not just because you don't like people as you're walking past. Mm. Don't use that as an attack system. Although, it makes it look pretty mean. But if you saw that coming towards you, yeah, you're not gonna try and get in the way. Now that I've got a buggy, I get to be aggressive towards other road users, right? Other pavement users. That's seems to be the rule. Four, very simple, very straightforward. And then to take it off, there's a button. You've got a button here. Do that. Sorted. I think that's everything. Thank you very much for watching. Pip's having reverse sneezes, so I should probably wait until she's finished before I try and do an outro. So I think that's about it. Thank you very much for watching. I hope this was useful. I hope you found it of some benefit. If you've got any questions, please let me know in the comments below. I know this isn't a typical video of mine, but with fatherhood looming, you never know, there might be more fatherhood-based reviews. Thank you very much. Bye-bye. You're not even nearly pointing at me now.
Yeah.
Are you? Looks like it's pointing down there.
don't know how big in figures you are, but
okay.
There you are. You could, did you want to collapse it with just with nothing on it?
No.